For this show, we're going to have three festive recipes. Each one has a story, and one of them at least is a frustration that I have with one of the dishes. That's why I created this. My mom, one of her favorite dishes are corned beef at saka pork and beans. During the Japanese time, she was a kid at that time, every time there was a celebration, let's say somebody's birthday, it was a treat for them, and my grandfather daw would take out a can of corned beef and pork and beans. So to them, parang, wow, celebration. So my mom would even eat corned beef straight from the can, yung hindi paluto. That's how much she loved the corned beef. My daughters, on the other hand, I don't think they realize it. They got the genes of my mom, and they love pork and beans. Me, on the other hand, I also love pork and beans. But my frustration is, every time I have pork and beans, it's more of beans and pork. Kasi yung pork, konti, tsaka puro taba pa. So what I thought, sabi ko, why don't I do this? Why don't I create a dish with loads of pork and the same taste? So I came up with this dish called Pata Pork and Beans, okay? It's actually very, very easy to make. For this recipe, I prepared one pork pata, pork cubes, cooking oil, chopped bacon, garlic, onions, pimiento, green bell pepper, tomato paste, pork and beans, pork broth, barbecue sauce, garbanzos, and patis. Look at this. So I have a pressure cooker here. Okay, I have water inside. I'm gonna put in pork cubes, two pork cubes, just to flavor it. Okay, and then I'm going to put in my pata. You know what I use? I use the front part of the pork pata because that has more, more laman, ano? Okay, so you have to submerge the pata in water. Normally, what I do here is I turn on the heat. The moment you hear the first hiss, when I say 20 or 30 minutes, the moment you hear the first hiss from the pressure cooker, then you start counting. 30 minutes, okay? Now, since what I'm going to do with the pate is I'm really going to boil it to death. I'm going to go 40 minutes, okay? So what I've done is, let's say, I went 40 minutes, I turned it off, I let it breathe, I let it soften and everything. I remove the pata and then remove it with a fork and knife lang. Get rid of the bones and then slice it up into chunks. I'm gonna show you what it looks like, okay? So this is the pata that super tender. I cut it up. I cut it in chunks. These are the sizes. Oh. Now, this is the broth. Some of the broth at least, okay? And I'm going to start sauteing. Now, my suggestion really is to get a pressure cooker. No? If you don't have the time, you know, it'll save you on your gas if you're using gas. Because something that'll tenderize in 2 or 3 hours or a little more sometimes with beef, no, you can tenderize in even less than 1 hour. We have some oil. Then we add in our bacon. At pwede niya. Okay, so imagine all the ingredients I'm going to put in here. Then let me add in our chopped garlic. Okay. Let's let the garlic shrink a little bit and the bacon shrink also so that the flavors come out. And then I have here some onions. Garlic and onions. I'll saute it. But anyway, garlic, onions, bacon. Garlic, onions, bacon. Then we add in our pimiento. Okay. We add in our green bell peppers. Yan. And just saute away. Okay. Now you imagine all these flavors going into the sauce. You know, I don't know if this generation today will appreciate pork and beans, no? Kasi I do, but then again, I look at my kids. Daniel and Ali, and my boys also, Frank and Arturo, they love it also. So I really get yung small packs lang. Marami siguro mga 15. Let's put in our tomato paste. At this point, we will add in our pork broth. Yan. I can tell, oh, from the stickiness of the broth, there's gelatin in it. Dagdagan pa natin. Yan. Then I'm going to put in some barbecue sauce. Sarap dun. I put it on everything. Okay. mix. And then we have some patis. Then we have some garbanzos. Yan. Let me add in our pork and beans. Yan na. Yan ang pork and beans. Okay. Sarap yan. Now, tikman natin muna. Wow, sarap niya. Comfort food. Alam mo, the flavor of the pork and beans came out. Parang, wow, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to reduce this a little bit lang just so that the flavors will be more concentrate. And then, siguro mga 5-10 minutes in the pan, and the moment that reduces a little bit, the flavors are going to be a little bit stronger. And then we can add in our pork pata, okay? Nag-reduce na yung ating ano, yung sauce natin. We'll add in our pata. This one has a flavor of our callos, di ba? So, close lang siya. Difference between the pork and beans. Pork and beans is a little bit soft. I keep on mentioning corned beef because parang ano eh, parang duet yun, corned beef and pork and beans. But this one is done. Leave it uncovered and simmer it for another 30 minutes. This is the type of dish that if you serve it the next day, it tastes even better. Try mo. This one is called pata pork and beans. You have to try this. It's different, it's unique, and it's delicious. The next dish that I will be making is pork steak. Learn my recipe here at Casa Daza. This next recipe naman is a pork steak recipe. You're familiar with ano, bistek, di ba? So this is my version of pork steak. For today's pork steak, we have 6 thick pork chops, 1 inch thick. Soy sauce, calamansi or lemon juice, cooking oil, onions cut into rings, butter, and all-purpose cream. Now, in a restaurant of a friend of mine, si Robbie Goko, if I'm not mistaken, he has a very popular pork chop dish, and that pork chop is so thick. So when I saw it, why don't I do that? So what I did, I went to my butcher and I had them cut pork chops. Usually they're about 1/2 inch, so I had them cut 1 inch thick. Now, what I've done is the skin of the pork chop, if you fry the pork chops with the skin intact, it's going to fold, no? So what I've done is I've put serrations on the skin so that it doesn't fold. So I have some soy sauce, okay? Or seasoning liquid is okay also, okay? And then some calamansi or lemon juice, okay? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to marinate or just dip my thick pork chops in this, okay? Thick pork chop in this. You know, I've been doing this for such a long time and it always works. Yan. Normally, what you do here kasi is you pat dry the pork chops because it's gonna splatter the moment I put it in, no? But it's okay. I have a cover to protect myself. So, calamansi or seasoning liquid and lemon or calamansi, and then we start frying, okay? Let's wait. Remember, this is thicker, so it'll take a little longer to cook, ha? Yan na. Yan. Ano na lang, I won't force the issue. I have 4, I'll fry it all at the same time, and then I'll fry the other 2 later, okay? We'll come back to this one when it's ready to flip. Okay, so this one is ready to flip. Look at this, oh. Ooh, look at that color. Okay, so, because it's thick, it'll take a little longer to cook. But be patient, okay? Because I want, you see the form of the pork chop didn't really move because of the serrations from the fat, no? Okay. We'll come back to this one. When it's fully cooked, then I'll set it aside, okay? So our pork chops are done. You have to remember, we have to cook this fully. Hindi pwedeng medium rare ito. I'm like, oh, look at that color. It's beautiful, oh. Okay. Okay. Look at that color, oh. Beautiful. Okay. Okay. Isip natin. And then, I'll cook the last two. Okay. Okay. The moment this is done, I'll finish it later. Right? I just have to put the done last two pork chops on the plate, and then I'll show you how to finish this. Okay, this one is done. Look at that. Okay. This one is done. Look at that. You have to be careful about the strength of the fire also, kasi sometimes it can burn. Okay, so what I will do at this point is I'm going to remove some of the oil. You know, remember, some of the pork fat went and combined with the oil, remember? So wait. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in our onion rings. Okay. Rings and just cook this until it becomes nice and wilted. So some people like their onion rings raw. I like mine just to play it safe, is a little bit wilted. Okay. You might be wondering, do I have to caramelize it? No, I don't have to. I just want this. See if you notice the color of the onions. They picked up some of the marinade, so it turned dark. Okay. So you combine that just when it becomes wilted, actually at any point, if you like it raw, you can put it on top already. Okay. So what I'm going to do is get our chops, put it here. Yan. Okay. You see some of the drippings? Look at this, ha? I'm going to return some of the drippings. Sayang to eh. The flavor. Okay. And then, I'm going to pour the onions over our chops. Okay? Wow, my pan is so hot. Then, remember the leftover marinade that I had? Okay, so in a way, it's going to deglaze the pan also. We can add in some butter. You can stop at this point. Okay? And serve it as is. Or, to reduce the saltiness of the soy sauce or the seasoning liquid, what I do is I add a little cream. Okay, I'm going to add in our cream. So this is my version of the 1-inch thick pork steak. Okay, so we pour in the sauce on our glazed onions and pork chops. And that's it. So this is my version of pork steak that can be served for any festivity. Sarap yan. Let's raise your cooking skills by a notch with our last pork recipe, embutido. Learn my recipe for embutido right here at Casa Daza. The next dish I'm going to make is a very popular festive dish. This one is my version of embutido. In Marikina, there's one that they call everlasting. This is my version of my steamed embutido. To make my embutido recipe, we have ground pork, cooked eggs, pickled relish, chopped pimiento, finely chopped carrots, frozen peas, chopped onions, raisins, liver spread, cheese, mustard, banana ketchup, seasoning liquid, and eggs that will serve as a binder for all the ingredients. What I'm going to do is I have some ground pork. Okay, make sure your hands are clean because you're going to use your hands. You have some pickled relish. Okay, you can imagine the taste already from the ingredients alone, no? Pimiento, carrots, okay, green peas, onions, halo-halo lang actually, raisins, sweetness naman, pickled relish, sweetness, I put liver spread, okay? So may pagka-rich yan. And then our grated cheese, you know, I just use the local cheese, masarap. Then I put some table mustard. Okay. And then to season all of these ingredients together, we put banana ketchup. Ooh. Okay. And then we put some seasoning liquid. Siguro mga 3 tablespoons siguro, ganun. Okay. Well, not too much. And then 2 whole eggs to bind all of these ingredients together. Okay. So it'll hold. Now, like I say, make sure your hands are clean. And we're going to start digging in. Ayan. It's nice, ano eh. When you use your hands talaga, just make sure that your hands are clean. Ayan, oh. Look at that. Look at that. That are still pinkish in color. That means it hasn't been touched by some of the flavorings or the other ingredients. But now, parang more or less, I can see already it's equally spread. Okay. Ayan. Okay, so what I'll do now is I will just wash my hands and show you how to assemble this, okay? Okay, we're ready to assemble. You know what we will do? Be flexible. We are going to steam, okay, instead of bake. But you may bake also. Okay, so what I'll do, get some of this mixture, okay? Lay it on a foil like this. Okay, get the cheese. Okay. And I will cut it. Cut this cheese. This is the one that melts fast, eh, no? Yan. Okay. And what I'll do is I'll lay the cheese here. Yan. Yan. And then get some hard cooked eggs. Down, then pour some of this, more of the ground meat mixture on top. Okay? And then use the foil as your guide. Okay? You know, like this one is way too thick, but you know, this will work. You know, it's really up to you what size of embutido you like. Some of this sauce or the liquid will fall into the pan, and you can make that into your gravy also. Okay, so what I've done is you have to make sure that the embutido is tight, okay, and you use the aluminum foil to make it tighter. Usually, an embutido, I like my embutido chilled. So when it's still warm and you cut it, it'll break. Eh? So you want to have it chilled so that it's easier to cut. Okay, so what we will do, I have here my improvised steamer, okay? You put it on top and just cover it. After an hour, mga hour 15 minutes, just to be sure, you remove it from the kawali and then let it cool, okay? And then keep it in the refrigerator and then you can slice it when it's chilled already. Like I say, it'll also break down if it's still warm. Okay, so this one is my steamed embutido. Let me taste it, no? Kasi from the ingredients alone, you know, this is going to be a winner. Yeah, but you know, it's still collapsing, no? Init pa, oh. You know what I can smell? I can smell the liver spread. Saka yung banana ketchup. Okay. All it has to do, firm up a little bit, chill it a little bit, serve this with toasted pandesal. Boom. Try this. This is my version of embutido. So there you have it. These are my 3 festive dishes. Both kind of unusual except for the embutido. You have to try these dishes. Pork steak, pata pork and beans, and embutido. So there you have it. These are my 3 festive dishes. Pork steak, pata pork and beans, chicken steamed embutido. I remember my pata pork and beans. Sarap niyan. And then, I have my, I'll try two of these nga. Okay? Pork chops natin. You know, somebody who tasted this just told me, the cream adds a little gentleness to the sauce because the sauce can be overpowering a little bit. It actually is very nice. The problem with that, when you put the sauce without the cream on the rice, you're gonna eat a lot of rice. So that cream kind of tames it down a little bit. Plus the onion, sarap. Now, our pata, pork and beans. Notice. There's a little sweetness, stickiness from the pata. Ang sarap. It's different. It's delicious. And I'm sure your family will love this.